I was in physics class, and the teacher was saying, bumblebees can't fly. It's impossible. Aerodynamically, they can't fly. And I was on the second floor of the classroom, and I looked out the window, and there was a big, beautiful bumblebee staring at me right in the eye. And he was doing something that this guy said he couldn't do. I've never forgotten that lesson. And so from then on, I understood that, well, he was right. They can't fly. They levitate. Natural law, there's only one law, and that's you either know or you don't know. There's no guesswork. It's like you know when you're hungry, you know when you want to sleep. These are knowing, these are all natural knowing. It has a great deal of difference from the synthetic or invented system of belief. You can believe this, but somebody can come along and get you to disbelieve, and vice versa. So you go around and around and around all your life sometimes, for some people, and never seem to get anywhere. Until you stand up and look into natural law, which is either you know or you don't know. And if you don't know, then you proceed along a line that's comfortable for you. You proceed into the subject matter that you're studying, and you don't give up until you know what it is. There's no more guesswork. And you don't have to try to do this, because if you're following natural law, it will come to you. All you have to do is start. The first step is just, I want to learn this, I want to know this. And just start it, and pretty soon, it will start teaching you. The bumblebee, when he starts to beat his wings, when he starts to flap his wings, there's a little cavity, a hollow cavity next to the larynx inside his system that's hollow. And when he beats his wings, he starts to resonate this energy, and it goes back and forth, just similar to somebody hitting a high C and breaking a crystal. It's the same thing. It's resonant. What they do, they resonate. And when they resonate, they eventually reach the resonance of the field around them. The Earth is operating on a frequency of 8.5 hertz per second, or something. Once this bumblebee hits that resonant frequency of its surroundings, it becomes a free agent. It creates a magnetic bubble around itself, and it can go anywhere it wants. Well, that's not in any of the science books. You probably never see it there either, but that's what happens. We have a conventional way of doing things, and then we have a natural way of doing things, and they're totally different.
a bee with a little radar hunt on them. Which means it's
first of all, the bees are flying much faster than predicted. An incredible 30 miles an hour. Even if they're really clever. In spite of 30 mile an hour crosswinds, whether out or back, they all fly.
We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.